I guess you are watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you are trying to open a program I've recently installed. This error arrived. The problem can start because FModex64.dll is missing from your computer. It's a very critical error and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is open your favorite browser and search for FModex64.dll. You can choose any result you want. I'm choosing the first one. It is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. And you can see if you download option based on the architecture and version. To know your architecture and version, click on start and search for system information. Here you can see mine is 64 bit and I'm updated to the recent Windows update. So in this case, I'll be downloading the first one. I strongly recommend you to read this page. As the download complete, hit open. The downloaded file has the DLL file in it. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then new volume C, Windows, and find a folder named system32. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. Then click on the downloaded zip, drag the DLL, and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace, and click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check by typing the entire file name. We can see the file is placed in 32-bit folder, so job is done for 32-bit users. Can go and restart your computer. If you are a 64-bit user, you need to do a little more. Open this PC one more time, local disk C, Windows. And this time find a folder named syswow64. This is the home of 64-bit DLLs, and similarly drag and drop. In short, the 64-bit users need to place the file in both 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder. Check this one more time. Similarly, by typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in 64-bit folder too, so job is done. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download the latest Windows update and install your program again, and that will surely fix it. And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.